Good morning to all. Be strong but not rude. Be kind but not weak. Be humble but not arrogant. Good morning to one and all who are gathered here. Myself, Dr. B. Srinivasan, heading the Department of Microbiology. First of all, I would like to welcome our today's chief guest, Dr. Vaibhav Jadhav, for the today's event, National Webinar on National Education Policy in Honing Research, Prospects and Future Trends. Welcome you, sir. I'd like to welcome all the participants who have taken interest in registering for today's webinar and have come over here on the online platform virtually to join the event. Welcome you all once again. Before starting today's session, I would like to give a brief introduction about our chief guest today, who will be delivering the talk on today's theme. Please let me deliver his introduction. So Dr. Vaibhav Jadhav is currently working as assistant professor in the Department of Education and Extension. He is the coordinator of School of Education, coordinator in National Recourse Center for Arpit and Swayam in Savitri Bai Pune University, Pune. And on his part in research, he has completed research projects funded by NUEPA on governance and leadership in higher education of India, UNESCO Bangkok project on tele-collaboration in teacher education, UPE phase 2 project on e-governance in universities of Maharashtra, and ongoing international project he is doing on teacher education with Southeastern Norway University, Norway, and tuning. And he is also involved in one of the Indian project with University of Deusto, Spain. And he is also doing a project in e-governance and management in Indian university projects funded by IUCT, MSU Baroda, and digital citizenship education funded by UPE phase 2 SPPU. So he is involved in a lot of projects, both in national as well as with international collaboration, especially in countries like Bangkok, Thailand, Seoul, South Korea, so on and so forth. And he has completed two PhD scholars and 10 MPhil scholars. And they are right now under his supervision. And coming on to his awards and achievements, he is awarded the prestigious C.V. Raman Postdoctoral Fellowship Award by UGC, New Delhi, in the year 2016. And has completed postdoctoral research in University of Massachusetts, USA in 2017. And he has secured Maharashtra State Secondary Teacher Education Association Award and for the best research paper in 2009, and Young Teacher Education, Young Teacher Educator Award in 2019. And this was awarded by Yashwantrao Chavan Maharashtra Open University, Nasik. And publication record, he has authored and co-authored 10 books in education and related books related to education. 3 books are published at international level, and around 20 research publications were put under his name at national and international level to his credit. And in extension activities, he has initiated a number of interventions and reforms in curriculum at different levels of education sciences, and participated in the formulation of action research culture in SEERT at state level and environmental education at national level. He has initiated to use new educational technology, the name of Edomo, in the teaching learning procedure, which is offering a communication, collaboration, and coaching strategies for students. So with these small snippets, I would like to welcome Dr. Vaibhav to deliver his talk on today's theme. Welcome, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And participants, kind request to you, please, at the end of the session, you need to discuss on the theme that has been discussed. If you have any queries, you can post then and there on the chat box, which will be forwarded, which will be visible to the guest, and you can also interact with him. Please make this session a lively one by interacting then and there with the guest. Thank you, sir. This forum is yours.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I'm very happy to deliver such a new topic with the learner professor here. So I think can I share my PowerPoint presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, I think it is visible.
One second.
Yes, sir, visible.
Yes, sir. It's visible. You need to open your PowerPoint so that we can see it. Your screen is visible, sir.
Okay. It is my request to It is my request to Srinivasan, sir. So meanwhile. Maybe I always, it is very difficult, you know, nowadays in the COVID and post-COVID, delivering the lecture in front of one screen, that time it is very difficult to those who have completed the Bachelor of Education like me, because we have a very habit to work with the classroom. So my request to Srinivasan, sir, meanwhile, I always ask some question or something to you. So please reply me so we can say that as per your instruction, we can make it lively. So I need your help,
sure.
Srinivasan, sir. So
definitely, sir, we'll do
it. Yeah. So before going to discussion about, first thing I would like to say here that I am not teaching to you anything else, because when I discuss with the Professor Srinivasan, sir, then we had one discussion that we have to focus on what kind of research opportunity in future as a teacher, because you know teacher is one of the very important pillar of the society. When we are thinking about the sustainable society or inclusive society, that time we need to think about the education. And we all the teacher, I am always saying that we all the teacher, from primary education to higher education, we all the teacher are the main part of entire process of sustainable society. So first, I'm not asking question, but I would like to know that in the chat box, how many teachers are completed their minor major, or we can say how many teachers completed their minor major project. So can you type in the chat box that which are the funding which you know that and which you received such kind of funding. So I would like to see how many teachers are, which kind of funding and which kind of funding agency. So the chat box is open for you. Please type the your known funding agency for the research in India and in the world also. DBT, DST, CSIR, yeah, yes. Universal Studies on its own, yeah. Yes, plus, please. I would like to see some, ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. Rajalakshmi Raji, MOEF. I don't know what is MOEF. You can unmute your Rajalakshmi ma'am, Rajalakshmi Raji. You can unmute and you can please. Ministry of Environment and Forestry. Okay, fantastic. So those are working in the field of environmental science. Hopefully, maybe environmental education also. Yeah, Rajit Kumar would like to say something. Yes, come on. As per the instruction of the Professor Srinivasan, we need to discuss, we need to make it live. See, this is not one way, please. If anybody would like to speak, you can unmute and you can say something about the funding agency. Yes, please.
So then and there, I will transliterate you because participants would also like to have a bilingual presentation.
Please, sir. You help me. Please.
Yes, sir. Participants, sir, enna kekkararunaa. நம்மளுடைய படிப்பு சார்ந்த ஆய்வு சார்ந்த துறைகளுக்கு வந்து எங்கெல்லாம் வந்து ஃபண்டு கொடுக்குறாங்க கவர்மெண்ட்ல, ஏதாவது ஒன்று ரெண்டு நிறுவனங்கள் இருந்தா சொல்லுங்கன்னு கேட்குறாங்க. உங்களுக்கு ஏதாவது நிறுவனங்கள் தெரிஞ்சதுன்னா சொல்லுங்க, நான் சர்ச் பண்ணி கூட சொல்லுங்க. இன்ட்ராக்டிவா பேசுங்க.
பேசிக்கிட்டு Yeah, thank you, Srinivasan. Sanjit Kumar is saying about the Indian Council of Social Science Research. Yes, right. Even ICER, science research, science education research. I assume that all the learned professors, those are joined this discussion, are from the science background and psychology, social science background. Isn't it, sir? Srinivasan, sir. Yes, sir, log science and social science background ke hai, right? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So Sajit sir is very active. I'm very happy. Yes, sir. Thank you, Sajit. Yeah. So my concern is that, and when I discuss with the Srinivasan sir, and when I discuss with any teacher, because if you see the new structure of the national education policy, and when this policy is saying about the higher education. So the entire part two, if you see the policy, the document of the policy, the second part is completely devoted with the higher education. And this second part is focusing on the teaching. It means teaching learning process, research and extension. In coming days, yeah, Rubini would like to say something. In coming days, there are the three type of the universities. For example, if you see the some universities dedicatedly working with the teaching, some are only for the research, and some are working for the teaching and research. So new structure will come out very soon, and we need to ready, we should be ready for to accept all these things. And I hope, Srinivasan sir, I would like to say here one thing, that we are really fortunate, we will have a great future in the field of the higher education, because the movement, you see that if once Srinivasan sir, I would like to say again one thing here. If you see the revolution of education in India after 2000, last 20 years making very interesting, very drastic changes in the field of education. If you see, the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyana was introduced for the strengthening to the primary education. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyana. Then once we thought that, okay, we have achieved something in the primary education, in the field of the primary education, we started, we focus on the secondary education, and the mission was that RMSA, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyana. When we are somehow sustained, somehow achieved in the field of Madhyamik Shiksha, we can say secondary education, RMSA, then we are continuously working on the RUSA, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyana. This is the entire, you should be understand this kind of the development which is happening in India. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyana, then Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyana, now we are focused, very keenly focusing on the RUSA, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyana. So this development is going on very fast, we can say, and we are the main part of this entire process. Some teacher from primary education, some teacher from secondary education, some teacher from our faculty, or we can say our area, higher education. So entire people are working on this issue. So today it is my responsibility that National Education Policy 2020, and what kind of what kind of focus on a research part. If you see, National Education Policy, so I would like to take 2 minutes for only on the structure of higher education. It is suggested one umbrella, that Higher Education Commission of India. This is one big umbrella. Everything under this commission. And this Higher Education Commission has four important council. The four important councils are National Higher Education Regulatory Council, which is focusing on all the regulations which are very important to functioning the higher education institute at national level. Second council, which is very important, you know, that National Accreditation Council, now it is known as a NAC. So how we can maintain the quality in education, in higher education, administratively and academically also. So this council is already established. It is known as a NAC. But this is a new name which is suggested by this commission, this policy. The third one is that Higher Education Grant Council. Focus on only the grants. Regarding development grant, research grant, and entire grant type of there, like UGC is working already. But nowadays UGC is covering all kind of the aspect. But this council is focusing mainly on a grant. Fourth is General Education Council. General means under this, you know, all kind of different kind of the regulator authorities, for example, NCT, National Council for Teacher Education, basically focusing on the quality of the teacher education in India, AICT, Agriculture, NAB, like this way. So all kind of small, we can say, the regulatory authorities are covered with the General Education Council. So this is the structure of coming, we can say, the higher education of the India. Now, we have to focus on the research. If you've gone through with the, I hope that maybe you have already you had focus on the draft which is published before coming the final document of this NEP 2020. In the draft, you can see the entire lot of discussion were happening on research. So in the final document, the part number 2 and chapter number 17 focusing on research, entire research. And how we can maintain the quality academic research in all the fields of the higher education. It is not for only the education, it is entire the field. For example, nowadays broadly, if you see the broadly the four faculties of the higher education, for example, science and technology, social science and humanities, interdisciplinary, and the fourth one is that commerce and management, which are, this is a big bird view, we can see the all field of the higher education. So this chapter is devotedly focused on the academic quality research. How we can inculcate and nurture the research culture in university and higher education institute. Srinivasan sir, if you would like to translate something, you can. Otherwise, I'm continuing.
Yeah, you can continue, sir. I'll translate it then and there.
So, this chapter suggesting that we have to establish, and this policy suggesting that we have to establish National Research Foundation. And all the agencies, already some of my friends here mentioned the different kind of the funding agencies. All agencies are working under this National Research Foundation. And National Research Foundation itself have some kind of fund for providing, and we can say, promoting the research culture entire India. So it is very interesting if you see. I would like to ask here to my friends, anybody would like to say about their experience who has completed any project from any funding agency, either local or either higher education or either international? Don't type. You can speak in your own regional language also. Srinivasan sir, or I request to anybody who can translate in English. But I would like to listen from that any one experience who is completed research from any funding agency. Any funding agency, not only from the UGC and all these things. Any funding agency.
Participants, in the ப்ராஜெக்ட் வந்துட்டு ஏதாவது ஃபண்டிங் ஏஜென்சியில முடிச்சிருந்தீங்கன்னா அதை பத்தின எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் எப்படி இருந்ததுன்னு கேக்குறாங்க.
I think I request to Sachit Kumar. I think he would like to say something. If you are No. So see the application and writing application. I hope maybe a lot of teachers have completed their major and minor research with the UGC, because it is very mandatory to the college also. Yes. No one is there.
Okay. Sir, let me share my own experience actually.
Okay. I had
a chance to do a project under DST SERB as a junior research fellow, and then when I joined as a faculty, I had a chance to guide PG candidates, wherein we got a project from Tamil Nadu State Council of Science and Technology. Like the sanctioning was for this was that was the fourth time. Okay, we were consecutively applying for 3 years, and the fourth time when I applied, we got the funding. But then the sanctioned amount was for doing all the projects, recurring, non-recurring, everything. The time delay for sanctioning of the fund was around one year. Where by the time the fund reached us, the project was almost, we were about to complete the project. And during that time, management supported us to complete the project. And anyway, after submitting the reports and all, we received the fund from the organization. And with that, we had a chance to extend the project objectives and complete it. So one thing we observed was that parallelly applying for grants from the research institute, to the research institute is one of the part, and carrying out the basic research which we are doing right now at the lab, that should also continue side by side, so that grants would also help us support on extending the projects in whatever way the results are being produced.
And I think, Srinivasan sir, I think it is mandatory to each professor to complete at least one research, because it is a part of the NAC. NAC once visited to your university or your college, generally they are asking about research to the teachers, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
We so, have criteria 5 for research and criteria 3
yeah,
for research.
I'm coming on the point, right? Thank you very much. I'm coming on the point. So it is important to all of you. It is my request to all the teachers, those are working in the higher education institute, which known as a college system in India. I request to all the teachers, we need to apply for small projects for our college, for our institute, for your own professional development. And that's I'm saying to here, that's I would like to focus into here. That we need, Srinivasan sir, is it, I think the class is full. So what is the Facebook link? Can you share on my WhatsApp, please? My students would like to join. That's why I'm requesting to you. So when we are thinking about the research, so this initiation taken by the NEP 2020, it is very important. That's why the entire philosophy of the National Research Foundation is that this research, so every time we are talking about the R&D, research and development, if you read the policy document, you can find out now see, after the independence, near about we completed 70 years, so now we achieve minimum, we can say, ample ideas in the field of research and development in higher education and primary education also. So now we are talking about the research and innovation. So instead of the research and development, we are talking about the innovation. And this National Research Foundation is focusing on the part of the innovation. So that's why they are promoting, they will be provided to a lot of funds for us that to promote the research and innovation in the field of the higher education. So these two things are the main part of the sustaining, main part of the society. And this we can say, research and innovation in higher education definitely will be helpful to sustaining a large and vibrant society and to develop the economy of the country. This foundation is also trying to, we can say, promoting the research entire country in the young aspiration minds. And this foundation also work with different kind of the ideas, and they are welcoming. I hope you know this foundation, once this will be work in exist, or we can say work, it's coming in exist, that time it will be the definitely fruitful for us. The document is focusing on primary activities. This is the main, we can say, objective, or we can say primary activities which is done by the, which will be done by the NRF. For example, to identify the very perfect, accurate, interesting proposal from the society of the higher education, and providing this different kind of the fund to the teachers. All proposals should be reviewed with the, we can say, peer reviewed. Then they will be provide these things. They are trying to inculcate the research infrastructure. They are providing some seed money to the institute, academic institute, to develop the research infrastructure in colleges, in university. Also, this foundation is work as a liaison officer, we can say license, between the researcher and between the government branches or funding branches. Or we can say nowadays, if you see, I would like to share one development of Maharashtra government. We had a new University Act, and if you would like to really would like to learn, or really would you like to read, you can download this act, Maharashtra University Act, which is already we have on our website. And we are also focusing on the collaboration of higher education institute and industry. So this kind of academia, industrial and education comes together, and they will work for the nation building. For example, see, our university established in Pune. Pune, maybe you know that Pune is the very hub of the information technology and automobiles and industry. There are a lot of industry. So university, recent vice chancellor and our university is trying to work with the industry. We are trying to collaborate with the industry. And what are the requirement of the industry from the academia, like university and higher education institute? We are trying to develop, we are trying to construct such kind of, we are trying to develop such kind of the production. What they want, which kind of human resources they want for their industry. And with their collaboration, we are focusing on what you want for the industry. And as a responsibility, as a government, as a part of the government, branches of the government, as a university, we are developing such human resources. So this National Research Foundation is, we can say, trying to linkage between the industry and university. Of identifying the outstanding research and their progress. So basically, the entire higher education, I mentioned that there are the four bird view, or we can say broadly four part of the higher education, that art and humanities, and second is science and social science. So generally, I'm not saying that innovation is happening only in science and social science. Maybe the innovation is happening in arts and humanities also. So this is this kind of focus of the research. And this is the what kind of scope of this entire NRF, that this basically National Research Foundation, already I told you that entire higher education is divided into three parts: science and technology, social science, art and humanities, like this way. So they are providing, or they are identifying the good research area from this four faculty, or four broad area. I'm not saying faculty only, but apart from this, there are the number of different kind of the issues which are very important for the development of the society, that health, agriculture, and environmental issues. So how we can develop the research according to the needs of the society, not according to the how your research will be helpful. You know, we in from education we have one terminology, it's a very well known terminology, the SUPW, socially useful productive work. SUPW, socially useful productive work. It means in the faculty of education we are always trying to focus on all activities, which activities are helpful for the society, and our all teacher educators busy to design such kind of the activities. Very interesting part in the bachelor of education and master of education. When we are thinking about the fund, what is the see USA, Japan, China, they are providing more than 2% of their GDP for the research grant. If you see in India, currently we are spending 0.69% of GDP on research and innovation. So government of India is thinking about that we can try to we are trying to spend at least 1% on GDP. So this entire seed money will be useful to inculcate the sense, the culture of research, we can say quality culture of research among the universities and colleges, we can say higher education institute. The policy is trying to focus that they want, this policy is suggesting to all the stakeholders, all the researchers, that we have to develop the best of best proposal for the useful for the society. Basically, for example, they're suggesting that we have to work with the inter and intra-institutional projects. For example, you know, in the SCRT, you know, we have a national for example National Council for the Teacher and Teacher Trainings, like this way we have a State Council for the Teachers and Teacher Training, the SCRT and the Research Training Center. So the research, which suppose there is a research and which is working with your institute, a teacher is doing the research in your institute, that time they should be work with the other institute. And once they are working with the institutional level, so this kind of the collaborative, this kind of the collaboration happening with the help of the research, which will be the becoming the sustainable development. So it is, this is the main focus, mentor and work as a mentoring, work as a mentee institute, and develop some capacity building program, develop some new ideas among the institute and the other institute, and we work on it, providing and forwarding all kind of the research culture entire India with the help of different kind of the programs. And also this National Research Foundation is focusing on, already I mentioned that, research infrastructure, because you know in the field of chemistry, physics and field from the Srinivasan sir, microbiology, biotechnology, now they such faculties needs very strong infrastructure. I would like to say here, Savitribai Phule Pune University, in the Savitribai Phule Pune University, we establish one central facility, center instrumentation facilitation center, which basically very devotedly we work with the chemistry and all branches related with the chemistry. So once we will be the able to develop such facility among the institute, that time it will be helpful for the budding researcher. So they can develop their own ideas with the particular infrastructure. And this foundation is doing the same thing. This foundation is providing all kind of the facility to the institute. Suppose some facility we need to hire from the international level, we can avail such kind of the facility with the help of the National Research Foundation. So it is, but it's only depend on your proposal. What kind of proposal, what kind of your ideas regarding the science, research. If this such ideas are very, very, very vital, useful for the society, useful for the nation, useful for the your subject, definitely this foundation will help you. So this is one kind of the philosophy behind this foundation. What kind of area, if you went through the entire document, the old also, the draft, which is the first draft of this policy, you have to read the draft also. Then you have to read the final 66 pages policy. This foundation is trying to focus on very major areas. This is not only this one, but major that what are the climate change. So this is the big challenging problem in front of the world, that climate change. Nobody is trying to predicting all these things. So this we need this this area is attracting the attraction point of the researcher. Then how we can manage the population? See, the another big problem in front of is the population. I am not saying always that this is a problem, but how we can manage, how we can utilize this kind of area. And this is also area of the research, interested area of the research of the NEP 2020. Biotechnology, digital marketplace. See, the market, those people are working in commerce and management, and some teachers are also, maybe they have some knowledge about the stock exchange market. So how this kind of market, when I discuss with this issue, digital marketplace, with the researcher, so each and everyone, not only from faculty from the commerce and management, each and every teacher, every personal, every citizen should be know about the market. Then this is a digital citizenship. They should be know about the digital market. What is the upcoming up and downs? What is going on in the market? What kind of affect such market up and down on their day-to-day life? So these are the kind of research areas are inviting by the NEP. And another thing is machine learning, artificial intelligence. These are the very hot area nowadays in the higher education. So these are some areas. There are another sub kind, another areas that, for example, cleaning, clean drinking water, sanitation, quality education, healthcare. Health education is also important. Proper transportation system in each city and each village. It means that each village should be connected with the rural and urban area. We can say they should connect it each other. So people can mobile, they have mobility with their cities, air quality, energy, infrastructure. So these are the broadly some areas suggesting by the NEP 2020 in the field of the research, any research, any person. I would like to say here one thing that, see, apart this research culture, why we need to conduct the research in the higher education? Because see, when we are thinking about this various areas, that time, for example, the entire area, that time we, why is it, why the government, why the policy is spending a lot of money on research and innovation? Why they are identifying such issues? Why we need to focus on the artificial intelligence? Why we all see, this is not only for the part of computer science faculty. This is the part of all the, this is the area of all the researcher, all the teachers of higher education or any kind, any teacher from the education. So artificial intelligence and machine learning are working with you. If you see nowadays, if you see the after in COVID-19, or we can say after COVID-19, the entire scenario change of higher education. Government of India had one mission, ICT, national mission for the ICT. Insisting always, Government of India insisting to use the technology in a classroom. But I'm not saying that because of COVID-19, but because of this incident, now the teacher is quite busy with the technology. I know the importance of the face-to-face teaching learning process, but at least now we are trying to use the technology intervention in teaching learning process. I'm saying the second side of this scenario, that those students, those learners are not able to join the institute, higher education institute, maybe they will be get this kind of that's why the machine learning and artificial intelligence are important for the and this areas is, all the areas of research are important to enriching the quality of research in higher education. And second thing is that we can maybe sustain the gross enrollment, we can increase the gross enrollment ratio, or we can say in the higher education by 2030 we need to achieve 50% gross enrollment ratio in higher education. So my question is that why we need to work, why we need to do the research, why the national education policy focusing the more than 12 and 10 pages on only on higher education and research, why they are insisting? Because if you see the NAAC criteria, 3.3 number criteria regarding the research, if you see all higher education research mobile, this first criteria and fifth criteria is not for applicable to the colleges, but rest all criteria are the applicable to the college. For example, research mobilization for resources, mobilization for the research, innovation ecosystem, research publication and award, extension activity and collaboration. That is why the NEP is focusing on the research, different research area, and it is inviting all the teacher, it is asking to all the teacher, you have to do the research. They are ready to pay. They have some kind of ceremony. If you see the fund, near about 1% government is ready to provide near about 20,000 crore. They are assigning annual grant for the. This is a golden opportunity for the, all the teachers, those are working in higher education. Those are trying to take research from the funding agency. That's why they have a golden opportunity. And these are the different areas. So we need to work with the interdisciplinary type that we have to, suppose population and management. So a teacher from the geography, a teacher from the social science working with the management people. So they're like this way. Artificial intelligence teacher, those teacher from the teacher education and teacher from the computer science, they should be work with digital marketplace, economics and commerce management, like this. So these are the really challenging and attractive fields for the research in front of the all the teacher from higher education. And deliberately, I'm adding this slide that if you see the NAC criteria, we have to show something for the NAC also. I'm not saying that for showing to NAC, we have to do research, but this is one kind of the motivation behind it to doing the research. Again, I would like to say this is the two important word behind the research, that NAC and CAS. So everyone is need to complete the stages for the career advancement stages and scheme, which is vacancy scheme and NAC. So for that purpose, at least we need to focus on the research. So I would like to ask to Srinivasan, sir. Sir, this is, I'm not saying that for this purpose, we have to do the research, but at least this is a motivational 2 points for our life, and at least for NAC, at least for the CAS, we have to identify the funding agency. We need to apply the proposal for the such funding agency, and very soon National Research Foundation is opening. Government of India is trying to already they are developing and establishing this foundation, and it will be really good for us doing research. So I think from my side, I would like to ask some questions. Srinivasan sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, go ahead.
So this is 2 point I'm deliberately add towards Srinivasan sir, that NAC and CAS.
Yes,
and NEP is focusing on very rigorously focusing on research criteria, and already at the initial level I mentioned about the types of the according to this policy, institutes are working with the purely working with the teaching universities, research universities, and some universities working with the teaching and learning. So this is a very golden opportunity nowadays. Different already some people, DBT, DST, CSR, RCMR, ICSR, all the funding agency existed there, but the one umbrella is that National Research Foundation is coming to exist, and they have their own funding, own fund. So it is a golden opportunity to in front of all the teachers from higher education. And it is my request to all the learned professor, we have to, at least we have to complete 2-3 projects in your duration of your in your career. So if any question, I would like to give the answer, please.
Yes, sir. For the discussion per se, let me start the session with my own question first of all. You said about interdisciplinary research, which is for a decade or so, from the beginning itself, it's quite lacking in India. As of now, we come across faculties and research institutes starting up collaborative research projects. But then when you empirically look on to the progress of collaborative or interdisciplinary research, it's quite lagging. As an educator, what would be your primal suggestion to enrich collaborative researchers and interdisciplinary researchers? Like that, more than interdisciplinary research, you can also talk about the transdisciplinary research. So I would like to you to shed a few limelight on it.
Srinivasan sir, actually see, last 20 years, you already point out that government establishing specific research institute in India. For example, I haven't a lot of ideas about your faculty, but for example, physics research lab in Bhopal, some regional labs, some labs established in, for example, NCL, National Chemical Lab in Pune. So government is trying to establish such research lab. What I'm saying already that National Research Foundation have an objective to establish the research infrastructure. And one point which is mentioned there, how we can connect with this research institute. It is my request to all the teachers, those are working in higher education and in any area, we need to establish network. When I was in USA, I found that without a network, without your own group, see, isolated people or individually, you cannot do anything else. So you have to, suppose Srinivasan sir is from the microbiology. So we need to establish some kind of your own network with the university as a teacher of the institute, as a teacher of the college. We have to develop some network with the university people. I'm not saying that there is very important, give the importance to the university teacher. No, but we have to start. That's why the small scale discussion forum, research katta, your students. So we can start with this network and we can identify the research funding agency. Definitely you will get, it is not within a one night you are getting all kind of the research. No, you have to develop your own, network and you have to achieve what you want. So come together two, three people and they can make it research in realized. We can say they can realize the research. They can live the research.
Sure, sure. Thank you. Participants, if you have any queries, you can unmute and discuss with the speaker, or you can even type on your chat box.
Yeah, you can type the question in chat box also.
Session
or you can unmute yourself and ask the question.
Yes, sir. Session is officially open for discussion.
Yeah, Rajalakshmi, yeah, please.
Yes, sir. I have one doubt, sir. How does NRF support women's in research? Have any special scheme, sir?
Sorry, please.
How does NRF, National Research Funding Agency, support the women's in research, sir?
Oh, okay. Already I mentioned some research areas, but you point out very nicely that in the last policy, National Policy on Education, in PE 1980, it is focused very specifically focus of women education. In new policy, NEP 2020, it is not directly talking about the women education area or research area. But if you see the objective or the philosophy of the National Research Foundation, they are focusing about the sustainable society. They are focusing about the inclusive society. So inclusion and sustainable society cover all the aspect of your areas. Rajalakshmi.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Yes.
Sir, I've got some questions from YouTube participants as well. One question is like, how can we enrich ourselves to support minor consultancy works at college level?
Regarding fund or regarding ideas only?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Small like data processes for government institutions, for example, commerce department per se, or any other department like computer science department, like back end work, processing works for banking, like that.
So, yeah.
But for colleges, the opportunities provided by industries are less as of now. So
yes.
I suppose they are asking like how to enhance the process, like enhance the teachers level to make them do consultancy, real-time consultancy to industries.
Srinivasan sir, those are working in a college level. If you see the example of Savitribai Phule Pune University, we have established relationship between the college and department. For example, already I mentioned about the facilitation center which is developed by the Savitribai Phule Pune University in the campus. In basically those are working in the chemistry or regarding all branches of the chemistry. So they have a some kind of small fees, and they have a collaboration between the institute and university, and our university labs are open for all the teachers those are working in the college. Because sometimes what happened, some college established in very rural area and they lack about some infrastructure facility, and that time they can contact. So it is depend on the college and it is depend on the policy of the university. I suggest you, those people are working in their college, in their affiliated institute, and they have to write their university and establish such kind of the MOUs between the college and between the college and university. So they have to establish such MOUs and they can start with the work with the university. All universities from the India, they have responsibility. Each university has its own responsibility to develop the affiliated college. So I request to the particular person who should be write to universities. Definitely university has some policies to work with the college, to support to the colleges and higher education institute. You need to take the initiation. I saw one professor in the group that Sudarshan Tapsale, who is my colleague actually from the chemistry. If he is there, because this is a very vibrant department and big department in Pune University, and they established one center. Okay. And the center is supporting. I think this is the only one center in the field of the chemistry. I don't have a lot of ideas, but Sudarshan sir is there?
Yes, sir.
Can you say something 2 minutes about your center?
Sir, this is a research center, and who is doing PhD MPhil project. So he can collaborate with the research center that is in the chemistry department. So data analysis, suppose PMR, NMR, experimental data, their content analyzed, and which is already the NMR instruments also already, and XRD also having higher cost, that is 1 crore, 2 crores. Such amount is more for the colleges. So university gives a centralized facility for the other colleges all over the Maharashtra and others also. You can contact with the university and fill the form, and minimum amount you can get the facility from the institute.
Nice. So this kind of centers are promoting, they are helping to the budding researcher. And Sudarshan sir already mentioned that this is not for only Pune University. It is open for all the teachers from entire India. And I think you are from microbiology. Maybe you know that about.
Yes, sir. And one more question from Geetanjali Nirgude. NRF is only for teachers or students also?
It is only for teachers. Those are working in higher education, they can apply for projects. And they can test. So this is the part of the research. Teachers.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, students would be benefiting if teachers are funded for research.
Yes. All research from all faculty are helpful for the teachers. Basically, the students is the central point of all research. Basically, in art and social science and humanities.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I have a doubt regarding. So, what are the global scale research opportunities in NAP?
Already, see, if you, I don't know how many teachers are following the notices published by the UGC. Already, Government of India is working with different kind of the councils of entire world. For example, Erasmus Plus is there, Erasmus Mundus projects are there. There are some collaboration with the UK universities. We established And UGC is announcing, for example, Sivaraman Fellowship, which I avail actually. I am the example of this fellowship then. Some collaboration with the SAARC countries, some collaboration with the Asian Pac. So we need to focus on, see, NIR, National Research Foundation. Nowadays what happened, all circulars are published by the UGC. And sometimes we miss it. But in future, NRF, National Research Foundation, specifically focus on the national and international collaboration. So sometimes we miss to see out all the circulars from the UGC. Now we can avail such opportunity with the help of the functioning of NRF. So it's under the umbrella.
Thank you, sir.
One more query, sir, from YouTube stream. How NAC reports the function of autonomous university directed by HRD? I think the participant wishes to know how would be the functioning of NAC after NEP has been established, and how would it impact on research? Like, apart from the IRF, will there be any drastic modifications in the processes which is already going on, or will there be any new changes that would be coming in terms of research?
Yes, Srinivasan sir.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah.
The participant has asked.
I got it. Actually, see, now the functioning of all these councils is not existing right now. So this is the one idea. So we need to wait for few months. Then it will be work on. It will be work in action.
Yes, sir.
See, this is the policy document. If you see the 1986 National Policy on Education, 1986, after the 4 years, there is the program of action, POA, 1992. So I'm not saying that this will be take a lot of time, but once the PO, program of action will come out, then we can say that what kind of benefits. I hope everything will be fine, but the POA is coming out very soon and we will see what is the action plan. So we are waiting for the action from the action plan from the government. Once it will be come out, then we will work on it. And we can understand what kind of benefit actually we are getting. I hope, I'm not saying 100%, but this time we will get the 100%.
Participants, if you have any more queries, you can discuss with the speaker.
Yeah, this is my, if you, they want to ask some question, this is the my, okay, I hope this is the my contacts, you can contact me. I think Srinivasan sir. No question, I think. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, please display the last slide, your contact slide. Yes, sir, it's noted.
Thank you, Srinivasan sir. I would like to say two words. Thank you very much to you and giving me this opportunity to discuss with you and your all the teachers and learned professors. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. With this final talk, I would like to invite Dr. Sajit Kumar to propose the vote of thanks for today's session. Sir, please.
Thank you, Srinivasan, sir. Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Sajit, Head Department of Psychology, and I am here to present the word of thanks. I would like to thank our resource person, Dr. Vaibhav Jadhav, for taking out time from busy schedule and enlightening us with the knowledge of national education policy and research. It gave deep insight into the topic and revealed some interesting facts. And thank you very much for your valuable time, sir. And also, I thank all the participants present here and for paying your attention and learning. And I thank you once again to all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Sajit. Thank you, Vaibhav, sir, for being here virtually and presenting your views. Looking forward to meeting you in other sessions.
Thank you to Shankar Narayan Pelleri. This is the main person who is connecting.
Yeah, he is the one who connected. Thank you to him as well. And thanks to all the participants. Participants, this is for your instruction. Please stay online while we share the feedback form on the chat box so that you can fill it up so to receive the certificate. This platform will be open for another 10 minutes until you fill the feedback form. Yeah, the link has been shared on the chat box. Please enter the feedback and submit it.
I get this crazy idea.
Participants, for your kind attention, hope you have filled all your feedback form. The feedback form is ready now. Once you filled your feedback form, you will get your certificate to your registered email ID. Please check onto it. If you have any queries, you can notify me through the following email, which I'm texting you right now on the chat box. That is the email ID to which you can contact if you have any queries or any technical problems in getting the certificate. Please notify us.